everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and Windows 11 brings a lot of new visual changes and refinements to Windows overall. And I thought we'd go over all of the major changes and features, as many of you have requested, since the Windows 11 Insider Preview has been released. Now, this will be available as a free update to Windows 10 users later this year, as long as you meet the system requirements. Now, these requirements could change, as quite a few people have been upset about them, since they don't necessarily have all of these requirements, but Windows 10 runs just fine. And those requirements are a 1 gigahertz or faster CPU, 4 gigabytes of RAM, 64 gigabytes of storage, secure boot, TPM 2.0 support, as well as DirectX 12 compatible graphics. If you meet those requirements, you should be good to go. Now, I'm currently running this on a custom-built PC that I made, and as you can see here, if we go into settings, it's an AMD Ryzen 7 5800X with 32 gigs of RAM, and it's also running an RTX 3090 graphics card. So that's what this is currently running on. We'll talk more about settings in a moment. Now, the first thing, obviously, is a major change is the start menu or start bar is in the middle of the display. Now, this can be customized or changed back to the left-hand side if you prefer that, but this works great if you have an ultra-wide monitor, for example. So that's been updated in Windows 11. They've also added rounded edges to everything. So if we click on start, for example, you'll see the corners are rounded. There's some nice sort of shadowing going on behind to give some depth. And this looks more like an Android app launcher, for example, where you have your pinned apps here with some new icon designs as well. And then also, if you want to see all of your apps, you click on all apps. Now you can scroll through all of your apps alphabetically. So that's an updated change and something they've updated with the start menu itself. There's no more live tiles, for example. Below, you have recommended, things you may have opened recently. And again, you can click on more and see more of that information or more different recommended applications you might have opened or documents. You also have your power menu here where you can restart or shut down, for example. Now on the desktop, you can see that we have a nice background. There's some new themes. I'll show you that in a moment. But if we right click on one of the icons, such as Microsoft Teams, which is also new and installed on every Windows 11 PC. So we'll right click and you'll see it's updated just a little bit. You have cut, you have copy, you also have rename and then delete. So this is updated like you would expect with the theming to match, the rounded corners, and also your obvious different properties and things like that that relate to this specific application. So just like you would expect, that hasn't changed much. It's just a visual overhaul. Now the next icon, as you can see, is search. If I click on search, you'll see that we have type to search, and then you have your top apps and recents and things like that. So just like you would expect before, your recent searches or things you've opened. And as you can see, we have control panel. All of the old ways to manage a Windows computer are still here. They're in the background running. If you want to change from small icons to category, for example, you can do that. So they haven't removed any of these yet. They're still here if you prefer that, but they've just visually overhauled everything to make it a little bit easier to use. Now, the next thing here, if we click on this, we have multiple desktops. We can create a new desktop, for example, with a different background and theme or different applications, or we can close that out and switch between them very easily. So you have that option as well, just to switch between multiple desktops if you prefer to use your computer that way. The next icon is widgets. They're bringing widgets back to Windows. And so as you can see, I have the weather widget, suggestions, calendar, and esports. And then you can customize the size of these with small, medium, or large, or remove them altogether. Of course, you can add a widget, and there will be more later on, but maybe we want to add tips and sports. You can add those, and we can resize these to match. So maybe make it medium, and now everything's matching now. So they've updated this with your news, sort of like the live start menu before where you had live news and things like that, but now it's a widget pane to the left. Again, you can search the web here as well. Now, if you have a touchscreen, you can slide in from the left and use that also. So they've updated this just to make it really nice. And as you can see, all the transitions and movements are very smooth, even for an early build. Now, something that they've been talking about quite a lot is called snap layouts. So if we go into Microsoft Edge, for example, and within Edge, we'll go home. If we hover over the maximize bar, these are all snap layouts that are the most commonly used layouts. Now, just like before, we can drag the window up to the top to make it full screen. We can drag it back, drag it to the left to snap it to the left or right. All of those things are still here, but the most commonly used layouts are available here. So maybe we want to go to the far left with this one. Then we'll open up Chrome and maybe hover over this, put it in the top right, and then maybe open up the Microsoft Store and we'll put this one in the bottom right. So you can just snap things wherever you'd like. And also the layout is remembered if you connect an external monitor, for example. So maybe you have an external monitor connected to a Surface laptop. When you plug it in, it will remember this. When you leave, it will go back to your main device and it won't just rearrange everything for you and have windows all over the place. So it's nice that they've added that. And if we close these and go back in, you'll see that it goes back to where it was. So it remembers those layouts. Now, the next thing you can see down here is the File Explorer. That's been updated just a little bit. It's just been updated to match what we had before with rounded corners, for example, and the newer icons. Everything you would expect is still here, though, of course. So there's those new icons. Let's close that out. And also settings has been dramatically changed and much easier, I think. So instead of the control center, we now have settings and you can see all of your settings here. Now, again, you can access anything the old way as well if you're used to that. But on the left, you have everything organized by Bluetooth and devices, network and internet, personalization, apps, gaming, accessibility, privacy and security, and Windows Update. Now, Windows Update has been updated as well, not only to be faster, but have smaller installs. And they said they'll be updating this on a yearly cycle as far as new features, so not twice a year anymore. So that's a visual change. I think I like this sort of consistency they're showing throughout the OS. So again, display, if you go into display, everything's very consistent in what you would expect, such as your scaling and your resolution, for example. So that has been updated as well. Now, personalization, again, it follows themes like we had before. So maybe if we switch to a light theme, click on that, and now you can see everything shifts over to a light theme like you would expect from before. And then if you want to change the theme here, you have more options to add your own wallpaper and sounds, for example. And of course, there's new sounds. There's different colors. Everything is customizable just like you would expect. So you have all of these different backgrounds. You have glow. You can see that's glow. Then you have this one here, which is called Captured Motion. Then also you have what they call Flow. It's just sort of a variation on the light and dark theme you have before. And then finally you have this one, which is called Sunrise. So Sunrise looks like this. So they're all very nice, again, with matching themes. And you'll see there's some small changes and glitches here as I have to mouse over some of these options. But for an early build, it's working quite well. Now, of course, if we click on our clock and date here in the bottom right, we have our notifications like we would expect. And then there's a little updated volume icon. If we click on that, we have some larger buttons for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, for example. Again, all updated with rounded corners just to match the overall theme. Nice animations throughout. So you have those options. Also, you have a security panel where it shows security at a glance. So this is very much like we had in Windows 10. If you go to virus and threat protection, for example, it looks basically the same as we had before. So this hasn't changed too much, just with rounded corners updated as well. Now, they've updated the Microsoft Store, and this one's fairly significant. So not only do we have our gaming with Xbox Game Pass, we also have Auto HDR like we have on the Xbox Series X, where it will take the different graphics from the games that are not by default set up for HDR and sort of enhance those areas to make them look a little bit nicer. That's built into Windows 11. But the biggest change, I think, is that you can use Android apps within Windows 11 through the Amazon Store. Now, Google Play could bring this later on. That's up to Google. But you can see if we go here, we'll click on TikTok. You have this available and you can install it on Windows 11 and use it here by default. It doesn't matter what processor you have. It can be an AMD like this one, Intel, or even an ARM processor on a Surface X, for example. So this should work on all the different platforms natively. So you'll be able to use all these Android apps as they're released for the device. So hopefully we see a lot more of those. Again, your normal apps are here as well. So they're encouraging different companies to add their apps here, like Adobe, for example, and not charging a bunch to add them here. So they can put their own app stores here as well. Now, they've also enhanced touchscreen support, voice and pen support with different haptics, for example. And like I said, there's all of the older features here that you would expect from before. So if you go to the start menu, right click on it, you'll see that we have device manager. You've got disk management, for example. just like we had before. The only difference is rounded corners, and it fades in and out like you would expect. So all of the things are here that you're used to using, maybe Windows Terminal, for example, or computer management. It's all here, just like you're familiar with if you need to admin this computer. So it's a really nice update, mostly visual with some nice changes just for usability. I think people have been using this at home quite a bit and realizing that it has some downfalls with Windows 10. They wanted to update it, make it a little bit nicer and easier to use with things like Teams, for example, built right in. So those are all of the major changes within Windows 11. Of course, there's other small changes throughout, and they'll continue to update this as it gets closer to its final release. If there's anything else though you'd like to see about this, let me know in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper if you don't have it already in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.